Guys, when it comes to prepping for SHTF survival, one of the most common excuses that I hear, and it is a legitimate excuse, but it's a lack of money, a lack of funding to actually buy supplies with. And it does cost money to prep, but it doesn't cost nearly as much as you probably think. If you read some of the blogs, if you read some of the prepper books, if you watch some of the other YouTube channels, you'll get the impression that it could, that you have to spend $25,000, $30,000, $40,000 or even more to actually prep for survival. You have to have the retreat back in the boondocks. You have to have the underground bunker. You have to have the tricked out bug out vehicles. You have to have the room full of firearms. And while that stuff is nice, and some of that stuff can increase your chances of making it through a really desperate situation, you can prep a whole lot cheaper and be better prepped, better prepared to survive a shit hits the fan, SHTF type of event than probably 90% of the population. I spent a couple of hours putting together a list of the bare basic necessities that you need for a 6 month period. I will add that list in the description box below with each product, each price that I found the product for. Most of the stuff you can get at Walmart or any place that sells groceries, you can find most all this stuff besides the grain mill and a couple of things like that. But the food, you can find this at any Walmart or any other retailer that sells groceries and food. So it's not going to be something that you have to order. You can go get it right now. That's a good thing, because you never know when SHTF is going to happen. It's actually happening right now. A small window to prepare right now. Right now we have all the rioting and looting and this pandemic or plandemic going on, all kinds of things going on right now. The national debt has went up like $6 trillion more in the last couple of months. We're in a SHTF situation right now to start. It's just going to get worse. So you need to get this stuff together now while you have this small window of opportunity to actually prep and get something done. You don't have to have, like I said, you don't have to spend $25,000, $30,000. It's nice if you can. If you have that, it'll increase your chances of survival. When you have the high-tech weapons, the high-tech night vision, the thermal imaging devices, all that, those things like that are nice toys to play with. And they actually can increase your chances of making it through an extreme event. But it's not necessary, and most people cannot afford to spend all the money to get all of those things that a lot of prepper channels and the books and stuff recommend. So we'll keep as basic as we possibly can here today. I put this list together. Like I said, I will add everything in the description box below with the actual poundages, the numbers, and the prices that I found doing my research. Now, prices might be a little different depending on where you're at, when you watch this video, and when you buy these products that I'm going to show you here today. I have some of the stuff back here. This is a representation of the whole thing I'm going to talk about today as far as poundage-wise and numbers goes. This is a representation to show you all what I'm talking about, to make it easier to understand. Guys, keep in mind that this is a basic list of food and other items for beginning preppers. This list and the amounts given in this video is for one person for 6 months. You could easily expand this out by doubling this amount to year supply for one person. Or for example, if you have more than one person, say two people, then you could double this and have enough food to do two people for 6 months, and so on and so forth. You can just keep adding to it and doubling, tripling the needed supplies for how many people that you have in your group or family, or how many months or years that you want to prepare for. The more you have, you can increase your chances of survival greatly. But one of the most important things to have is knowledge. Knowledge is really important. Without knowledge, you're going to be lost no matter how much supplies you have. If you're stupid, you're not going to make it very long in a shit hits the fan SHTF event. Okay, guys, one of the first items that we're going to talk about is salt. You'll need at least 4 pounds per person for 6 months. The next thing we're talking about is cooking oil. You'll need 6 quarts per person for 6 months, approximately. Pinto beans, rice, and other beans, like mixed beans and peas and things like that. You'll need 40 pounds total. The next item is powdered milk. You'll need 10 pounds of powdered milk per person for 6 months. The next item is sugar or honey or a mixture of both. You need 30 pounds per person for 6 months. And this one's the big one, guys, hard red winter wheat. You need 200 pounds per person for 6 months. I found this on Amazon for $100 for a 50 pound bag. So it'll be $400 total for 200 pounds per person. But if you can find this locally, you can get it a whole lot cheaper if you find it locally. You can also get field run wheat and get that a whole lot cheaper than you can get it like this. This came from Emergency Essentials. I looked on Emergency Essentials and they had sold out of this. I was going to link to those in the description box below, but they had sold out. But I found it on Amazon, like I said, for 100 pounds, or a 50 pound bag, I mean, for $100. Another item to consider is rice. You'll need 20 pounds per person for 6 months. You can get this at Walmart. A 20 pound bag at Walmart, I looked this up, and it was $8.48 at Walmart for a 20 pound bag. So that's really cheap. Add an extra couple of bags if you want. Can't hurt anything, that's for certain. Okay, guys, once you get the basics that I showed you already, you want to add approximately $300 worth of canned fruits, vegetables, meats, peanut butter, and pasta, etc. $300 worth per person for 6 months. Some other items that you will need is baking powder, baking soda, yeast, vanilla extract, pepper, and spices. Spend about $50 on those items. Spices, baking soda, baking powder, pepper. If you're going to be storing basic foods like hard red winter wheat, rice, and beans, then you'll need a good grain grinder. There's more expensive grain grinders on the market, and there's ones that actually run off of electricity. I wouldn't advise those. They're good to have right now while electricity is working, but for survival, I would recommend a hand-powered grain mill. Like I said, there's other models that are more expensive than this one, but this is a Corona grain mill. It works pretty well. You may have to send your grain through a couple of times to get it ground down to a fine flour so you can use to bake. But overall, it's a good mill, and at under $80, it's well worth the price. Something else you want to consider is some garden seeds. I got these on Amazon, and I've actually bought several of these and sprouted these. I sprouted some of these this year, actually, and they all, as far as I could tell, probably at least 95% of those seeds sprouted. And I bought these about 3 years ago, so they're still yet good. I will link to these on Amazon in the description box below. I think they were about 40-something dollars a package or something like that. I don't remember exact prices. I'll have to go back and look. And like I said, I will link to that in the description box below, and you can check those out. But having some seeds where you can till up your garden, plant in some pots, whatever you have to grow some of your own food, will make this food last a whole lot longer and give you more variety and give you some fresh vegetables. Something else that you need to think about is first aid. Get the best first aid kit and supplies that you can afford to buy. You'll probably have to spend around $100 to $150 on good first aid kit, quick clot, and things like that to expand this out. This is a basic kit at Walmart, like $20 this one was. That's a good starting point, but you need to expand on that a little more, especially by adding some quick clot to stop bleeding. Okay, guys, let's talk about firearms. If I could only have, and I only could afford, one firearm, it'd be a Ruger 10/22 rifle. You can get the basic model for around $300. You might find one used for $150. But the basic model is around $300, I think, the last one I bought. You can get these, put a good scope on it. You can use an iron sight if you can't afford a scope. Get some, about six of these Ruger BX25. It's a 25 round Ruger magazines, and they work really well. The only thing I've had happen to any of these is with this magazine right here, it tried to come apart in the center part here where it wasn't sealed together correctly, apparently, or something. So I fixed that by just putting some electrical tape around the magazine, and no more problems. But a good 22 rifle is good for foraging, ammo is cheap, and it's also, with the 25 round magazines, can be pretty effective for self-defense and home defense, actually. I chose a 22 rifle to suggest here today because 22s are easy to learn how to shoot, they are priced reasonably, and no matter if you're a big person, small person, male or female, old or young, you'll be able to handle the recoil from a 22 rifle. I recommend the 10-22 over most other models, but there are other good models that work really well, really accurate. But the 10-22 to me is my favorite for prepping purposes because it's reliable, it's easy to repair, and you can find higher capacity magazines. It's also, this comes from the factory with a 10 round rotary magazine. But for prepping, I would add some of these 25 round Ruger BX25 magazines to increase the effectiveness of this rifle in a self-defense situation. You also want to get some ammo. And I suggest 500 rounds at least for the 22 to start out with on a bare basic budget. You can see these here was 1400 rounds for $73. I bought these a couple of years ago, so the price may have went up by now, and it probably has, but you should be able to buy 500 rounds for $50 or less. Get more if you can afford it. Like this year, like I showed you, was 1400 rounds for $73 in one bucket at Walmart. Get as many as you can afford, but at least 500 rounds. Another thing that you definitely need is a good water filter. There's all kinds of different makes, models, and brands of water filters. This one is about $75, I think it is, on Amazon. I will look this up and put a link in the description box below. You can check this out. But this is, you don't have to get this exact kind. A Berkey filter is around $300, and they're really good. I have one of those. I've done a review of those before and work really well, but they're a little expensive. Something like this is, I think it's under $100. You hang this up in a tree. The filter is already in it, or hang it in a building or wherever. Put water in it, and your filter's here, and your water comes out here, of course, and this will filter 200 gallons of water, so it's a good option. But keep in mind that it's not going to be able to filter water indefinitely. Like I said, 200, the filter's good for 200 gallons, so you may have to get an extra filter or get a different type of water filter. Just as long as you get a water filter that has a good rating, you should be fine. But definitely add a water filter to your preps, even when prepping on a budget. Well guys, if you found the video useful, give it a thumbs up, sure to leave a comment below, and subscribe, give sure to subscribe, turn notifications, be notified each time I upload a new video.